I mean, really, BB. He's adorable. I mean, who doesn't want to own the BB action figure? He's great. He's amazing. He's got more stories than anybody I've ever met in my life. I think he's a little bit out of his element, and he doesn't know how to fix it without being a little bit aggressive.
Swampy there.
Greg is great. It's just good to have a friend, you know? Sometimes when you come to a country, a foreign country, a lot of times you're really nervous about all the mysteries that are there. You know, you hear about malaria, you hear about this, you hear about that.
Those aren't worms, those are leeches. Nothing.
By him, like, walking around barefoot and picking up things and whatever, you feel a lot more comfortable and the place becomes more your home. This is like actually making a friend out here, which I didn't think was really possible.
The oomph is a little gone from our group. I don't know why that is. I think that not eating is a factor of our mood. The first time I came upon the mud volcano was with Gretchen and Greg. We walked out of the woods like, you know, Lord of the Flies. And I think the others were quite interested in our discovery, so we took a group field trip. You heard a rumor that the other team caught a fish with their spear. Right now I am collecting stuff to build a stretcher.
I'm not a happy camper.
Greg talks into a coconut and thinks it's a phone. I didn't like the final decision for the SOS game. I thought it was quite silly. A smiley face? Give me a break.
I wouldn't say we're cocky. I just think that we're the best.
I'm going not knowing what's gonna happen and I'm nervous.
I wish I started slower. And then I wish it wasn't so far.
I'm nervous about votes being against me tonight because of I'm not a champion in the competition. We slept late for the first time since we've been here today. Everybody's a little bit on edge. Everybody's a little vulnerable today. When we go off, it's all about sex. It's all that's happening. It's a really passionate affair right now. Things are going great. You know, he reminds me of my friends back home, and so it's like I can totally, totally be myself with him. I can't. I mean, come on. It's a legend. I don't want to watch it die. I want to have it put on my plate and put it in front of me.
Great.
I just like to ignore that whole aspect of the food chain, the whole death part. I've interacted with the chickens as little as possible. I'm not petting them, putting them on leashes, taking them for walks, naming them, and, you know, calling them my very own. It does no good to befriend dinner. He's on a free ride, man. He's untouchable. I don't know how he gets through. He calls women cows, he doesn't do stuff half the time. His charm does get him through, you know? But he hasn't been so charming today, so maybe he's gonna get the vote. Joel seems to be ignoring the fact that we have one more immunity challenge before we combine the tribes, and if we lose it, somebody's being voted off. And he talks way too much about what he's gonna do when the tribes are combined, the strategy, the combination, da, da, da. What if he doesn't make it to the combining of the tribes? You know, he's Golden Boy, he's Mr. January, he's gonna have a calendar. He's Captain America, really. He is full of, don't do this, put it here, do that, watch out, da da da. Well, then get up and do it. Jervis, he's just as chauvinistic as Joel is. God, he just hides it better.
Oh, are you done?
Oh, that's it.
I want to vote for him at the next tribal council because he voted for me and I'm starting to just have like these little conflicts with him.
Oh my God.
Sean was even saying there's enough room for us in the hutch because enough people sleep outside, so it's gonna go quick. God, I hope it goes quick from here on out, you know, really. Rich came out and was like, hey, how are you? You know, he swam out, which was really nice. Sean is very intelligent. Sometimes he says interesting things, sometimes he tune out for a while and then he hits on something so you tune back in, you know, I mean, he's always going.
Yes. You see anything? Yes. Okay, great.
It's how men and women relate. You know, the women, we work together and women are always a little bit competitive in everything we do, you know? So it's like when you're working together, you're seeing what the other person can do and you're proving each other at the same time. Men can just sit down and talk for hours and walk away friends. Rudy was kicking me in the head and he doesn't care. It's not like that. I mean, honestly, if there was like a girl here who I got along with really, really well, it would be the same thing that way. I feel
like I have a friend and I have somebody who's my equal that I can actually have a conversation with.
God, some people are so nervous, it's sick. It's sick how nervous some people are.
We have the upper hand right now. Easy, we have four people that we can come together, have a vote, and get the next person off.
Those people flat out lied in front of a national television audience. I mean, they want $1 million and they're gonna get it. And I love Jeff's question, is a deserving person gonna win this money? The answer to that question is no.
Do you see them bringing these stingrays and stuff in? They're like still flapping around and they take this dull knife and they chop off their head. It's disgusting.
If I choose to watch my dinner that came from the sea be killed or not be killed, I would rather not watch it be killed.
So many times Rich opens his mouth and I just want to be like, oh, be quiet over there in the corner. You're not making any sense and you think you're so smart and you're just go home and go get your liposuction and go catch more fish because you're bugging me. You know, he thinks he's so above everybody and it's full of baloney, really.
Rich wanted to be naked for his birthday. Oh, fun. Show up a little more. I mean, he was doing it for shock value. It's Goofy, who walks around naked 24/7. I love that Rich gets annoyed with me. That makes me happy, and he really has in the past 2 days, and it just makes me want to egg him on more.
We had fun, you know? We had Pagong was a good place to live. Now we moved into the new neighborhood with the nasty neighbors.
The people who came in swinging were Rich and Sue. They knew. They're smart. They're very smart people. Although Rich is just a numbskull. God.
All you 16, 15 weirdos are making me nutty. I'll lose my mind.
People are wishy-washy, they're conniving, and they're stupid. And that's what's happening. And it's all out in the open for everybody to see. The decision that I feel I'm left with is, do I interact with these people, have fun, and just wait till my ticket comes up? Or do I try and strategize and try and make a difference?
Jenna and I were just, you know, goofing off, and Kelly decided to join it. And so I feel bad for Kelly, because here she wants to play, and Rich is like, oh, something's happened to you since these girls came, I'm really worried about you. Kind of putting her in her place and makes her feel a little self-conscious. By her being nervous and wishy-washy about where her loyalties lie, it's really making Sue and Rich nervous. I really don't know what's gonna happen at tribal council tonight. I know I'm voting for Rich. I know Jenna's voting for Rich. I know Jervis is voting for Rich.
Dirk got 4 votes. Gretchen got 4 votes. Greg got 4 votes.
Sean, come on, open your eyes. Sean is interesting because I'm debating right now if I want to vote him off at the next council because he's so scared of hurting somebody's feelings by voting for them that he's voting alphabetical order. I mean, he led the way for Jenna to be kicked off yesterday.
J for Jenna.
Feelings hurt.
It's like Sean walked into this and somebody forgot to tell him it was a game. And he's very concerned about people's emotions and feelings, which is wonderful, you know, if you're taking care of a pet, you know, not if you're playing a game called Survivor and the point of the game is to strategize and eliminate people.
Kelly is really hard for me to talk with about voting and about alliances.
They're so smart. They duped everybody.
I mean, because she could really be in for forming an alliance because you see her now being kind of pulled back and forth. You know, in one way, I think she feels that she wants to like have fun and be young and like, she said it, she was just like, I can't believe I'm in this group with these people. She's like, it's awful.
My legs are bothering me. I mean, I would be lying if I said my legs aren't bothering me. They hurt a lot. I have all these, and then I have these new ones. I can't sleep because they itch so bad. So I get a scar and then I itch it off and it's just like this never ending cycle. And they're gonna be like this for the next 3 years, you know? Bugs live in them. I mean, it's just awful. It's so awful.
I am feeling like I've been here for 59,000 days. The past 5 days have been the longest 5 days of my entire life. I miss my old team. Beach, you know? I am the last sole survivor of the Pagong tribe. I am a dying breed. Pagong is picked up one by one. That's obvious.
Now, I'm very confused at where alliances stand, and I think they're confused at where alliances stand.
Try and follow all this. I'm gonna give you all of what's happened up to here.
Rich and Sue are promising one thing to Sean, promising another thing to Kelly. Sue and Kelly are promising one thing to Rich, promising another thing to Sean, and then Rudy just sits back and watches it all happen. That's what's so interesting about this, is I'm getting to see the breakdown of the Tongi alliance, which is really funny. Everybody is very concerned at the money at this point. Like Sean was saying, a 1 in 6 chance of winning $1 million, and nobody's gonna throw that away. It's definitely what happens when you put a big chunk of cheese in a maze and let all the mice go at it, you know, and see who eats who and who scrambles on top of who. And I don't want to be any part of it. It's not a fun game now. Today is raining. Last night was raining. And I think tomorrow will probably be raining.
Sean is seeing that he's in a little bit of trouble and that he should probably have Rich out there because Rich is going to make sure that I get voted off tonight and not him. Maybe somewhere he's thinking that. He's smart if he's thinking that. I like that. Good job, Sean.
When Sean said first came to tell you the truth, I almost cried because I started thinking about my mom and I miss her a lot. You know, Sean just gets all the breaks. But, you know, it was good. It was good. I felt happy for him, and he is the family kid, you know, so it was good for him. It was nice to have a new face around and stuff. And we all got thrown a bone, which was amazingly, wonderfully great. Because now I feel like I could do this for 6 more days, and I definitely, well, I'm on a sugar high right now, more than I have been in a month, so I feel like I could do anything right now.
Kelly, she was a double agent, so to speak, you know, talking to the Pagong people, really trying to get in with them, and then relaying everything we said to her teammates.
This was a really difficult vote because, I mean, does anybody really think, you know, go Kelly, she's number one, I'm so happy she made it to the final two, or God, I'm glad Rich made it there, big winner. No, but I think we just want to end it, you know, let's go home.